I chair a group called the Tweens Nutrition and Fitness Coalition. And tweens are that 9 to 13 year old demographic, the in-between group. And we work to do obesity prevention in that population. So we do as much as we can to make physical activity and healthy eating accessible and fun for kids in that age group. Well, Better Bites is concession food reinvented. When you think about most concession stands, you think of hot dogs, French fries, nachos, soda, soft drinks, candy bars. And it's kind of ironic that when we send our kids out to play and get physical activity, the food that's available to them tends to be very unhealthy food. So with Better Bites, we wanted to undo that disconnect and have healthy foods where kids play. And we started with the Lexington Public Pools at Woodland and Southland Pools back in 2011. And Parks and Recreation partnered with the Tweens Nutrition and Fitness Coalition. And in the first year, 2011, added 8 healthy items to their snack menu. They kept the other stuff. It was a revolution, not an evolution. And it did pretty well the first year out. Sales were pretty good. There was a lot of public interest in it. So they decided to go back for round 2 in 2012. But we really upped our game. We did a Better Bites Needs a Slogan contest, and we got 625 submissions. And what won was Better Bites Snack Strong, and that came from 8-year-old Caitlin Smith here in Lexington. We also, working with Parks, really increased the menu of healthy items and the marketing. So some of the items on the Better Bites card are a yogurt parfait, which is vanilla yogurt with frozen berries and a little crunchy topping. We'll have the veggie dippers. We have a snack called Power Up, which is a combination of sunflower seeds and raisins. So you get the salty, sweet, crunchy. We'll have fruit, and as much as we can, we'll have local fruit in the summer. We found a protein bar that has 10 grams of protein, a Nature Valley bar. And we actually tested all these snacks with kids and got their input about which were keepers and which weren't. We had so much fun with the Better Bites Needs a Slogan. Now we want to source this from the from Lexington and get a name for our cart. And we're having a contest again. Whoever comes up with the best name for the Better Bites cart will receive $100 and 2 season pool passes to the Lexington pools. And it's very simple to enter. You simply write your name and a little bit of information about yourself, just where we can contact you, and your slogan, and send it to jocelyn.cohen@uky.edu. And the deadline for this is February 15th. And we will call the winner, and the other people will learn about it from going through Facebook, and we'll do a lot of announcements about who the winner will be. And then we're gonna start taking this cart out on the road, out into the streets, and start to change the way kids think about snacks, what their expectations are about snacks. And we hope over the long haul that these kinds of things will become more the norm, and we won't be loading our kids up so much with junk food and really setting them up to eat unhealthy food. If you have a place where you'd like to bring Better Bites, or you'd like us to bring the Better Bites cart, please contact me, Anita Courtney, at anitac@qx.net, and tell me where you'd like to bring Better Bites. If you've got a health club, if you've got a faith place where people aren't serving as healthy snacks as you'd like, we have lists that we can share with you. So it's gonna take us all. I mean, the obesity epidemic is a big problem, and it's not gonna take just one group and one response. It's really going to take all of us pitching in to start to normalize healthy food. So think about your life and where you might like to have some healthier food, and give me a call or an email, and we can talk about how to partner on that and start to make this the new normal.
Well, we designed a fishing pier to be handicap accessible. With the new FINS program here, Fishing in Neighborhoods, we wanted to build upon that and make an element where everybody can come out and enjoy, you know, even folks with, you know, handicap issues. So the new pier has parking that's accessible. Comes right off of that, where you know the grades are such that you can flow right out onto the pier and get set up. You know, it's really unique, and it, you know, it's a great place to bring even small children out to come, and you know, it's a modular system that goes in. There are 5x10 sections that went in really well with ease. The pier itself is not sitting on pylons that are driven into the lake bed. They're sitting on a cast foot, a plate, which really made the installation easy and pretty quick. The whole system went in within a day. It's aluminum. It's going to last. The decking is cedar, so it's built to last. And like I mentioned before, it's built to be accessible. There's a main walk. And off that are eddies, so to speak, that make it comfortable for, you know, when someone to get to that and set up and to be able to fish, you know, from the eddies. It allows them to move in and get comfortable and have a place to fish from, you know, where they're not feel like they're standing in somebody's way. The modular system allows it to be expanded upon. You know, you can add on, you know, another 5x10 section or two more or three more and just keep creating eddies, you know, out the linear center part of it. So we can get out further. That was the intent initially. You know, with budget constraints, we couldn't develop it fully, but we'll be able to in the future. Yeah, I wanted to get folks out, at least give them a shot to cast out to a deeper spot of the water, you know, to be able to maybe catch a more fish, you know. But you never know where they're going to be. They could be in on the bank or they could be out there. But I just wanted to give people at least a chance to cast out a little bit further. A lot of people fish just across the way there. They come to that one spot right on Richmond Road, which a lot of them park on Richmond Road. So. And you know, we don't want to see anybody get hurt, so we wanted to give them a place to come and, you know, to draw them away from that. So that was one thing that we hoped to do with the new pier. I would like for people who come out to fish to be, for us all to be good stewards of the land and pick up our trash when we leave. You know, it's great to come out here and enjoy this park and the water, but when you come out and you see bait tubs left behind and fishing line out there that's just left for somebody else to pick up or for even the animals to get in trouble with. Wish people would really take that in consideration when they're using our parks.
As a young kid, Lexington Parks and Rec always had a place for us to do something. It helped me in a healthy way to compete, but also learn how to be humble in victory and to have some dignity when we lost. Learning to do that allowed me to get to the point where I matured not only as an individual, but also as an athlete. I am a product of Lexington Parks and Recreation.
To escape the hustle and bustle of city life in the bluegrass, you don't have to venture far from Lexington to experience nature at its finest. In fact, Lexington has several fabulous nature trails to offer the outdoor enthusiast.
The Raven Run Nature Sanctuary is a remarkably short 12-mile drive from the heart of downtown. This is a unique 734-acre nature sanctuary dedicated to preserving and presenting early Kentucky history and the natural beauty of the Kentucky River Palisades. Over 10 miles of hiking trails provide access to streams, meadows, and woodlands characteristic of the area. There's a lot of fun for everyone when visiting Raven Run, not to mention tremendous photo opportunities. Some opportunities include birding at Raven Run, where you can see over 30 species of birds as they migrate through Kentucky. You'll learn to identify birds by sight and sound during this early morning program. On our Butterflies and Dragonflies walk, you'll learn how to identify many common species on the wing and learn about insect folklore by viewing a PowerPoint presentation focusing on the life cycles and identification of butterflies and dragonflies. The walk will last about 1.5 hours and covers approximately a mile of the trail. If your visit brings you to the area in the fall, enjoy the beautiful colors of the fall season at Raven Run on our Fall Wildflowers Walk. This program will focus on our meadows, which are carpeted in fall wildflowers.
Learn about the fascinating folklore connected to these plants and take advantage of great photographic opportunities.
And for the kids, try the Little Explorers Nature Tour. Bring your children to Raven Run for our children's program. Activities include a short nature hike and art projects with all supplies provided.
Our next nature trail destination brings us to McConnell Springs Nature Park, a 26-acre natural wonder hidden within an industrial complex in Lexington.
Heralded as the site where Lexington was named, it was settled in 1775 by William McConnell. 2 miles of trails wander around the sinking springs, vegetation, stone fences, and vestiges of historical buildings. McConnell Springs boasts more than 130 species of plants and numerous species of urban wildlife that reside at or visit the park.
There are a variety of hands-on activities for all ages at McConnell Springs Visitor Center. Here are just a few.
You can learn to carve a wooden cooking spoon or a wooden dough bowl with the Lexington Woodcarvers Guild. Make your own walking stick and join us for a hike for the whole family. Children 10 and younger make bird feeders and learn about the birds that use them.
In addition to the passive visitor who just wants to come out here and take a hike, we have a variety of scheduled or structured programs for the visitor. We've got weekend programs for the general public that are usually nature or history related, and we also have junior naturalist programs that are geared towards the youth 10 and younger.
McConnell Springs and Raven Run provide natural, cultural, and historical education opportunities for visitors when they visit Lexington. So keep it fresh. Plan to hit the trails when you visit the Bluegrass.
Parks are so critically important to the health, welfare, and just the good-naturedness of our community. The leadership of Parks and Recreation give us the opportunity to have these great facilities for economic development, for quality of life, to be out in the open, to be able to do things as families. The investment that we make as a community in our parks is so important to making a great city even better.
My name is Jill Chanel Wilson, and I am the Community Center Director here at William Wells Brown. This actually is a different type of setting for Parks and Recreation because we're located in a community school. And with that being said, that means that the school goes on during the daytime, and then in the evening, up until 9 p.m., the Community Center is open for activities for our youth, adults, and seniors. If you are looking for a cool place to come work out, get physically fit, network, and meet people, this is the place to be. Monday through Friday, we have activities from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. and then Saturdays from 10 to 2. So on Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays, our youth come in at 6 o'clock. Elementary students are engaged in organized sports games. We have boys group, girls group. We do arts and crafts. We have cooking classes, cool workshops for self-esteem and leadership skills. And then on Tuesdays and Thursdays, our adults come in. And there's activities scheduled for adults from 6 to 7. On Tuesday nights is aerobics. And then on Thursday nights from 6 to 7 is Zumba. And usually after those two classes, we have some cool activities if you want to do boot camp, kind of a little more higher intense activity. Also, we have yoga. We do a support weight loss group through the health department. We also have adult cooking classes. We do cooking classes for our youth as well. So if you want to live a healthy lifestyle, this is the place to come to, William Wells Brown Community Center. The coolest thing is everything here is free of charge. Right now we're standing in the weight room. This is our adult wellness room, and we have a few pieces of equipment. We have our treadmills, our elliptical, and our exercise bikes. We do free weights, and we have little stations of medicine balls and kettlebells. Basically, this room is filled to capacity starting around 5:30 p.m. to 9 p.m. We have two personal trainers and another staff that comes in, and they do intense work on different tonings, and if you want to target a particular area of your body, if you just want to lose weight or tone up, then you can come here and get those services for free. Actually, there's been a lot of people coming in since we've been open, and they have been very pleased. Each year we sponsor a weight loss challenge, and I work closely with the health department. They are my partner. They provide free resources, workshops, health literacy information. We also work with Central Baptist Health Works, and they come in and do a lot of our assessments for our weight loss challenge. We've serviced over, 1,000 people in the last 5 years, and we lost a lot of pounds as well. But this is a great place to come if you want to just relax, enjoy yourself, work out, participate in some of our classes. It's for the whole family. And like I said before, it is no cost involved. Everything is free. People come from all through the city. We're located in the East End area, 548 East 6th Street. But everyone that lives in the whole city of Lexington, surrounding counties, come and participate. A lot of people come after work and work out. They wait for their children to get out of school. We've had a lot of parents to come in. And the cool thing about it is if you want to work out, and you have children, you can still come and work out. We have staff that can accommodate your kids with like a lot of cool activities to keep them busy as well. And then they can be engaged in the youth activities while everyone is having a great time. If you made your New Year's resolution, like a lot of people have, in the beginning of the year, I want to work out, I want to get back in shape. Well, don't think anymore. Come right to William Wells Brown Community Center. We can supply all your needs to make sure that you do live a healthy lifestyle. And if you have any questions, you can contact us at 859-389-6678. That's 389-6678. That's the number to the community center. And also, we're also on the webpage for Lexington Fayette Urban County Government, Division of Parks and Recreation. So you can link on there. And the other thing that's cool about this facility, we also are affiliated with Fayette County Public Schools. So if you can't get our information from Parks and Rec, you can always find us at the Fayette County Public Schools website at William Wells Brown Elementary.